let's look at here. Here's a picture that Samsung's showing. They're giving you all the pinouts here. I mean, this is awesome. You got everything you need to troubleshoot this down to the gnat's butt on this. So they're showing you all these little connectors here. Same things that we were seeing here. These are your pinouts. So then, and all these different harness connectors that you're seeing here. Right, that's what they're showing you here, but in a pictorial diagram. And then they're showing you what the outputs should be or what they do, like RXD, TXD. What is that? What's that business about? Right, this is part of your data signal. Right, so RX is receive data, TXD, transmit data. So in other words, they're telling you specifically, this board does two-way communications on two dedicated lines. So if you're in a situation, well, is it the board that's bad, or is it not talking to the user interface? Is it not talking to some other digital load? Who's not talking to who? They give you enough information here to be able to put your meter on there and see, do I have any voltage there? By the way, that's all we were looking for in that Whirlpool inverter example. When they were giving you those voltages to look at in the different cases, let's jump back to that real quick. Just real quick. Was it this one? No. Let me go back. Here, yeah. These are still data voltages. Here in test three, remember, like it's exactly like it's an inverter, and so it works like any inverter. Mostly, it's got to get a data signal from the microprocessor to know how much voltage to supply to the magnetron. Just like on a variable capacity compressor system, just like on a front load washer. That inverter is getting a pulse width modulated signal, a PWM signal. And the microprocessor modulates those pulse widths to tell it how much voltage to make to drive the load. Same drill here. The inverter is getting its signal from this relay control board the microprocessor board. The inverter is getting its signal on how much voltage to supply to the magnetron. High heat, low heat. So that's all, and that's all you're doing when you measure these DC voltages. Your meter is giving you like an average of those pulses. You don't have to have an oscilloscope to know whether or not there's data on that line. Your meter is averaging it out. So it, for example, would look something like, you know, if you have and these are all going up to 5 volts, say, your meter is going to average this out to like half. You might call it something like 2.5 volts.